I can see Vivek Sai Ritvik. All of you can hear me. Hello.
Yeah, sir, we can.
Yeah, sir.
Vivek, tell something. I'm not able to hear you.
Sir, we are able to hear you.
Okay. Now it's clear.
Yeah, sir, it's clear.
Fine. Again, you have all off the camera. Sai Ritvik and Satvik. See, one question is, this question is based on 1 minute. No. Polynomial question, right? 1 minute. Calculate the perimeter of rectangle. One question I'm giving you, whose area is given, okay? I'm just written here the area of the rectangle. Calculate the perimeter of the rectangle, whose area is given. Whose area is this much? Who can solve this question? Just try fast. Calculate the perimeter of rectangle whose area is 25x square minus 35x plus 12. Calculate the perimeter of rectangle whose area is 25x square minus 35x plus 12. Satvik Nutakki. Can you hear me? Satvik. Satvik Nutakki, can you hear me? Okay. Try, children, this question.
Sir, which chapter are we doing, sir?
This is polynomials only. Sai Charan, this is polynomials okay. Only.
Yes.
Yeah, this is polynomials, not. Calculate the perimeter of the house area. Area, how to find area? Can you do you know that?
What? Sir, I have a doubt. In
LB, sir.
Sir,
LB, we have to find factors for this.
Sir, I have a doubt in polynomials.
Yeah, ask your doubts.
Sir, in constant polynomials, sir, the power for the degree of the constant polynomial, sir, the degree of the variable is always zero, right, sir?
What? Tell once again.
In constant polynomial, sir, the degree of the variable is always zero, sir.
Yes, yes.
And sir, I did not understand zero polynomial, sir. Can you explain again?
Zero polynomial.
Yes, sir. I have doubt in that.
1 minute. I'll just tell you the concept here itself. I'm just opening that. Polynomial introduction part is there, no? There only I'll just tell you. Here only is there everything. If you see the whole notes, what I've sent earlier, see what is zero polynomial? See, zero is only by zero polynomial. Zero only is term is there, no? Number of non-zero terms is what? Zero. Example is zero only. This is your
zero polynomial, sir. They tell that the constant of the zero polynomial is always zero, sir.
Constant of the zero polynomial is always zero.
Sir means the first constant means the first number in the polynomial is always zero, sir.
Yeah.
So then how
degree will not come? Degree will not come only, no.
Yes, sir. How is the degree not defined, sir?
Because here, if you are writing, why degree is not defined, you are saying, right? Well, I'll tell you right now. Pen. 1 minute. Sorry, Sharon. See, if you're writing zero, right? Sai Charan?
Yes, sir.
So zero means if you can't write here x to the power zero, because x to the power zero become one, so no problem at all, right? But if you're having any value, if you're having, suppose you are having one, or if you're having two, or you are having three, then you can write x to the power zero. Understood? If any constant term is there, then you can write x to the power zero. Understood?
Yes, sir.
But here zero is there. We can't write only x to the power zero. So this is what? For a degree of zero polynomial is what? Not defined. Understood?
Yes, sir. So that means why, sir? Because zero into x is zero. So the zero to the power zero is infinite, sir. Okay.
So now next question here, you just find. Calculate the perimeter. Any other doubt you're having, Sai Charan?
So no, sir. I am recapping the whole lesson from the first.
Calculate the perimeter. Can you find Pulastya? Vivek, Satvik. I'll just remove from the meeting. I'll just wait for 2 more minutes. Vivek.
Sir, 1 minute, sir.
Hi, Charan. On your camera.
Yes, sir.
Satvik is not able to on. No, just wait, Satvik. For 2 minutes, I'll just remove from the meeting itself.
Sir, 1 minute, sir, and log. I'm joining from 1 minute.
Okay, fine. Who's here? Fine, fast, children.
Sir, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you now. So what is the area of rectangle? Sorry, area of this triangle. How to find, do you know that? See, can you factorize this or not? Can you factorize this, all of you?
So 25x square minus 35x plus 12, sir.
25x square minus?
This 35x plus 12, that we have to factorize, sir.
Yes. If you factorize, then only you will get length and breadth, right? See the answer over here. If you're not understanding, you can just see the answers. How to factorize this one, okay? So, 25x square minus 35x plus 12, okay, is equals to 25x square minus 15x minus 20x plus 12, okay? Can you factorize this 35x square like this? So 35x, you can write it as minus 15x and 20x. See, minus 15x and 20x. Can you write this? If you multiply, you will get 300, minus 300x square. And if you add, you'll get minus 35x, right? Is it clear? Next, after
the factorize. So will it come in the algebraic identities also?
Algebraic identities also.
This so is just comes under the factorization of polynomials.
No, it's coming under that only. Polynomials only will come. Okay.
So this can is explain the two ways of factorization.
Which one? Explain what? Two ways of factorization.
Yes, sir.
Ways of factorization means you can do this only now. See, first and last. This is a 25 into 25. What will get? 300? 300x square. If you bifurcate, what do you get? If you on bifurcation, you will get? On bifurcation, what do you get? Minus 35x you should get, right? So what you should bifurcate? Two parts you should do. The first part is two parts, first part and second part you have to find. So what do you get? You'll get minus 15x and minus 20x. All right. Minus 15x and minus 20x. All right. Minus 20x. That's it. So 300x square can be bifurcated into two parts, minus 15x and minus 20x. On multiplication, we'll get 300x square. On addition, we'll get minus 35x. So your length and breadth is coming,
sir,
as...
If the middle part is 2, sir, means like there are 3 numbers, sir. So if there are 4, sir, what should we do?
If you send the question, then you'll get to know. Because if 2 is there, 225x...
Sir, can I tell, sir? So now it's like 25x square minus 35x plus 12, sir. Means there are about 3, sir. Means then if it is like 25x square minus 35x plus 2x plus 12, sir, then how to factorize?
So first you can add the Satvik. No, sorry, so Sai Charan. First you add x and x, it become only 1. So it become again three terms only. Understood?
Sir, yes, sir. If there are different variables in between 2, sir, then outermost 2 numbers, sir. How can we do, sir?
You can split into two parts. 2-2, you can make pair also, not a problem. Okay. You can make 2-2 pairs also. They are different ways, right? You are saying splitting this one, two parts, like 2 and 2, right? Even that's what you are saying, though.
Sir, no, sir. Sir, one.
You mean to say understood what you are saying? Means if here is one part, one part, one part, one part. Then how to factorize, right?
Yes, sir.
To making two pairs, grouping the terms, this two group and this two group. Like different ways of factorization is there.
Sir, can I explain?
Yeah, I'll explain. But this is not a part of this factorization, no, Sai Charan. You don't but know.
Sir, all it does not come in the polynomials.
This polynomials will come, that will tell you if we are having different. That is your seventh class, no, Sai Charan, those questions into different means type of polynomials. You should make grouping the terms, splitting the terms, so many terms like that are there, right? So so all of you got this one, how we are getting this one, 5x minus 3 and 5x minus 4. Sai Charan, this question is clear or not? This question is clear or not, Sai Charan?
Now we need to find the middle.
Yeah, middle term on find. So length and breadth you find here, right? By factorization. Correct. So how to find the perimeter? How to find the perimeter?
Sir, 2 into 5x minus 3 into 5x minus.
Okay, what is the answer coming? Just solve and tell me answers. Sri Anvi? Shriyanvi, tell the answer for this.
So 20x minus 14.
Hello, sir.
Srianvi, tell the answer. What is the perimeter of this rectangle?
I just came now only, so can I have some time to
Okay, fine.
So 20x minus 14.
20x minus 14. Okay. 20x minus 14 you are getting. Okay, fine. You solved already, Sairitvik?
Sir, I'm looking
yes,
at 50x square minus 35x plus 12, sir.
Yes. Sai Charan, we have to add this 2 and it should multiply also by 2. Okay. So if you add, what you'll get? 10x minus 7, right?
Sir, add
yes, sir. Then we'll get 20x minus 14.
What is the formula of perimeter of
the rectangle? 2 into L plus
sir, 2 into L plus B.
And that only we have to do. 2 into L plus B. So L also, you know, breadth also, you know, add both and multiply by 2. That's it. Is it clear or not?
Sir, 20x minus.
What?
20x minus 7.
Yes,
sir. 20x,
sir,
minus, 20x
minus 14, sir.
Sir,
minus
14. But
yes, sir. 20x minus 14.
Yeah, sir.
Sir, but how, sir, the brackets will go right?
Wait, I'll tell you. If you add what you're getting, length and breadth, you add, Satvik.
Sir, I didn't add the length and breadth, sir.
Sir, if we add the length and breadth, we are getting 10x minus 7.
Huh, and multiply
sir,
by
another way.
Wait.
Sir, then the, when we add, sir, the brackets will be removed, right, sir? So then you need to multiply it only with the 10x, right, sir?
Wait, I'll tell you. Just put the formula only and just telling you how it is coming, okay? So now see, this formula you know, right? Perimeter is 2 into length plus breadth. Now here length is 5x minus 3 and breadth is 5x minus 4. So this is your length, this is your breadth, all right? So 2 into 5x minus 3 and 5x minus 4.
Yes, sir. I thought, sir, it means.
Yes, sir. I got the same answer.
I've gotten same.
Sir, if there are only the means not the square brackets, if there are only the circle brackets, sir, then it will be like 20x minus 7, sir, I think.
See here, this is your length, this is your breadth. That's why you are just rolling about length into breadth. That's it. Understood. Length and breadth, you can take it out anyone. And just write here. 2 into L plus B. So 2x minus 17. Anyone having doubt still in this? Pulastya.
No, sir.
Pulastya on the camera. Srianvi, you understood this? Srianvi.
No, sir.
Where, which part you are feeling difficulty? First part you are feeling difficulty or second part? Which part you are feeling difficulty, Srianvi?
First part, sir.
First part. First part, right?
Yeah.
See, to find the length and breadth, we are just splitting the middle term. Okay, minus 35x, we are splitting into two
sir,
parts.
What should we do when, sir, if we give the perimeter and find the...
Sai Charan, 1 minute. She's asking some question. Let me clarify. Then you just ask the question. Okay.
Yes,
so here 35x is there, Srianvi. Okay, so this in, we have to, you know how to split the middle term, Srianvi?
Yes, sir.
So we have split it into two parts, that is minus 15x and minus 20x. All right. Split okay. It into two parts. So again, we are taking common two pairs, this first two and last two. You make pair, what do you get? 5x is common in that, 5x minus 3. Minus 4 is common, 5x minus 3. Okay. Then 5x minus 4 and 5x minus 3 will come in that. The first part is clear to you or first part is still having doubt? Is it
no,
clear?
Sir.
Second part?
Second yeah, I understood part? The second part.
Okay. So here length and breadth we got. Length and breadth 5x minus 3 and 5x minus 4. So we are just multiplying with 2, adding this length and breadth and multiplying by 2. So next question shall I ask? No one having doubt right now?
No doubt, sir.
Next question is, I should ask the next question as.
Sir.
Huh.
Sir, can we do it when he gives perimeter and ask the area of the rectangle, sir?
Not understanding your question. Tell once again.
Sir, means now he gave the area of the rectangle and is asking the perimeter, sir. So, can we do it when he tells the perimeter and we need to find the area, sir?
Area. So, from perimeter, can you find? From perimeter, can you find the area? Means length and breadth you can find by the help of perimeter.
Sir, yes, sir. Yes, sir. Got it.
If you can find length and breadth, then you can multiply and get the answer. Okay.
Sir, same method. Sir,
I do question 3.
Yeah, see this question you do. Now, find the value of the polynomial. 5x minus 4x square plus 3.
Would there be two values?
Yeah, two value. Because two answer question is given. No? At x equal to 2 and x equal to minus 1. This is a very easy question. All of you write in the chat box. This is very, very easy question.
Yeah, so.
I got the answer correct. All of you got this answer?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Minus 6. If x is equal to minus 1, they will get a minus 6 and minus 6 and minus 3, right?
Yes, sir. Minus.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
You can give one example of monomial and binomial having degree something and all.
Sir, yes, sir.
This is the same NCERT question what you have read before. Second question is, see, example you can give of binomial having degree 82 and 99 respectively.
Sir, both having 82 and 99, sir.
Yes, different this example you give.
So
say Sai Charan, what happened?
Got it, sir. The first one is 2x to the power 82, sir, and 3x to the power 99, sir. And the binomial, sir, it is 2x to the power 82 plus 1, sir. And second one is 5y to the power 99.
Sai Charan, you are saying no.
So x to the power of 82, example for binomial.
Yeah, that is correct. X to the power 82. Fine. Good. Next.
So then x.
Sir and
x to the power of 98 plus 1 to the power of
98 plus 8, sir. X to the power of.
Second one you can write x to the power 98 and plus anything you can write because binomial.
Yeah, x to the power of 95 plus 8 to the power of 3, no 4.
No.
So
98 you can't write only here. Right.
So 95.
X to the power 99 should be there.
99.
Plus x. Like this you can do.
Yeah. Yes.
Binomial having
degree. So I'm saying about binomial.
This is binomial only, no? X to the power 99 plus x. Yes, what is this? Binomial means two terms should be there. That's it. Okay. Two terms should be there. All right. Or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Next question. If you know the formula, you can do. Otherwise, you can't do.
But x to the power 99 into x is not a binomial, sir.
No. Into x has become monomial, you know. See, term is bifurcated by plus or minus, right?
Yes, sir.
Term is bifurcated with plus and minus. The x to the power 98 and x, if you write how, this become only one term, right?
Yes.
So next question is, you have to find, if you know the formula, you can just do easily. If you don't know, it's a bit difficult to you. See this question now. Find the value of x to the power 3, y to the power 3, z to the power 3, minus x, y, z. If x to the power x square plus y square plus z square is equals to 83 and x plus y plus z is equal to 15. Okay. So if you know the concept, you can do, otherwise no. Just try once. If you know that, tell me. If you don't know, just tell me you don't know. I'm just writing the formulas also in front of you so that it will feel easy. Okay. So formula is okay. This. See, this is a formula. What you can, you know this formula?
Sir, this we know.
This you know?
Sir, yes, sir.
Okay, one more formula will be used here, right? Which formula you should use here?
Sir, a square plus b square plus.
AQ plus BQ plus CQ formula, you know?
Yes, sir.
AQ plus BQ plus CQ formula, you know? See this, now this formula also can be used here. AQ plus BQ plus C cube minus 3ABC is equals to A plus B plus C into A square plus B square plus C square minus AB minus BC minus CA. All right. These are two formula you just think. And just try to do. I think you can do now by the help of two formulas. Just check now. Pulastya, silently, just check once. Now, if you can do this.
Okay.
If you know these two formulas, you can try. Say what?
Sir, not this sum, sir. I have a doubt in one sum, sir.
Okay, first you try this. After this sum, you just ask your doubt. Okay, Sai Charan. Do this sum, then you ask your doubts.
Yes, sir. Sir, if you substitute values and can we get the factor? Can we get the factor, sir, for anything?
What? If substitute the value?
Sir, if he asked like, so no, sir, I will.
Sir, I'm not getting, sir.
Not getting, okay. Anyone else?
I'm also not getting.
Not getting, sir.
Okay. Now, see, I'm just telling you the concept. Here, you know the formula a plus b plus c whole square, right? A square plus b square plus c square plus 2ab plus 2bc plus 2ca. But you have to find here aq plus bq plus cq minus 3abc. It's like, just like that formula only, right? X to the power 3 plus this, for this value you should find, right? Correct or not? You have to find this one only, no? So here x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3xyz. Now the formula is a plus b plus c, a square plus b square plus c square minus ab minus bc minus ca. This is the formula, no? So x plus y plus z, first part you know already. If you want to put the value, this part already you know, correct? Because yeah, sure. But other part, x a square plus b square plus c square, that also you know. That also you know or not? This, see, this one, this part.
Yeah, sir, we know.
That's why I'm saying this part already you know. This part already you know, only you should know this part. So to find this part, we have to use this formula, second formula. Because this part can be written as minus common and bracket, what you can write? AB plus BC plus CA. You can write like this or not. And if you find the formula AB plus BC plus CA from first, then you can put the value here, right? Is it clear?
What, sir, can you...
Sir, once can you repeat again?
Wait, I just put the answers only for a minute. I just put the answers only here. Then you understand. X plus Y plus Z is equals to 15. And wait. All of you try to understand this line, then you just try to understand this. You are getting it or not? The same formula I've written is written in the form of x, y, and z. Okay. The same formula is written in the form of x, y, and z. Why we are finding x, y, y, z and z, x, you understood or not? Why we are finding, I told, no, everything is given here in front of us only. Everything is given in front of us. Only we have to find the value of AB, BC and CA. Means, see, in the formula, this is given to us. Why is not? One minute. See what I'm saying? This is already given to us, x plus y plus z. Okay. Then a square plus b square plus c square, this also we know. That is x square plus y plus square plus z square. Next, what we don't know? Only we are not knowing AB, BC, and CA. Take minus common from these three. Minus common. In bracket, you can write AB plus BC plus CA. And to finding this value, we are using this one, check. And we are getting 71. Is it clear or not? Now it's clear, bit clear, Vivek?
Yeah, sir, it's clear.
Sairitvik, see the same formula we are using here?
Yes, sir.
Understood, sir.
Everything is given the question only for last part. To solve this last part, we are using a square formula. I told you before only, right? So we are getting the value as 71. All right? We are getting the value as what? 71. Now see. Next, what to do? 71, you can got. You got 71 now. Make using algebraic identities. Now you can get the value of this one also. Now see. Using identity, cube wall apart. See this identity now. Hope now you are understanding everything in this, correct? Sairitvik? AQ yes, plus BQ plus CQ plus this formula, if you know this formula, you can do everything. So see, this formula already value we know. This value also we know. This value already found, correct? All the value.
I got here. The formula, sir, but it didn't got the question, sir. How to do?
Question you're not getting.
Yes, sir.
Which question? This same question, right? See the yes, question. Sir. See what you have to find here. You have to find the value of this. See, Sai Charan. If you know two things, if x square plus y square plus z square is 23 and x plus y plus z is equal to 15. If two things you know, how to find the value of x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3xyz? That only is found over here. So if you know the formula of this one complete thing, then
sir, I got the formula, sir, but I'm not getting question.
Question only I'm saying, no. You have to find the value of this whole thing. If two things is given to you, then what else you want? If x square plus y square plus z square is equal to 83.
Oh, yes, sir, I got it.
If two
sir,
things
what, is then what about the minus AB, minus BC and minus CA, sir?
That's why minus is common taken. If you take minus common, what happens, Sai Charan? Tell me. Here you can put bracket. Can you put plus and plus here or not? AB plus BC plus CA, can you put?
Sir, but how, sir?
See, Sai Charan, if you multiply inside the bracket, that will become everything become minus only, no? Everything will become minus, right? See, this one, if you write here minus, and in a bracket, if you write AB plus BC
yes, sir.
CA. If you open the bracket, what do you get? Same thing you get or not?
Yes, sir.
That's why we are doing like this.
Okay.
So anyone having doubt in any steps? If I write here steps, anywhere doubt in the first step you are having doubt or second step you are having doubt?
No doubt, sir.
Very important question for your class. You might have not read. It is there in the NCERT textbook itself. Okay. So I don't think you are having any doubt in perimeter. Now this one, polynomials and all. Now one small question I'll ask you. This is based on square part. This is also based on formula itself.
Sir, I have doubts, sir, that it all after this.
Okay, fine. See the same question, same type question, but this is square part, it's not cube. You have to compute the value of 9x square plus 4y square, wherever if two things is given, x, y is equal to 6 and 3x plus 2y is equal to 12. Two things are given to you. Okay. Fine, try once. Kulasthya Sai Charan, on your camera.
Give me a second. I'm finding one thing. I dropped my pen.
Sir, what is a square plus b square?
What is a square plus b square? Formula is there, no? See, what is there, Sai Charan? If a plus b whole square, if you write, what do you get? A square plus b square plus 2ab.
Yes, sir.
So instead of a square plus b square, what you can write? Bring this one this side.
Okay, sir.
So this is 3x square plus 2y whole square, right? Open that and just put the values. That's it. I think you should do like this only. What you should do? 3x plus 2y whole square, if you do both sides, you'll get the answer. Sriyanvi, you're getting this question. You can solve this, Sriyanvi.
Yes, I'm trying.
See, all of you are getting this one or not. 9x square, the squaring both sides, what do you get? 9x square plus 12xy plus 4y square is equals to 144. If you are squaring which part? If you are squaring this one, last one, right? XY value is already given to you. So 9x square plus 44y square is equal to, can you write 144 minus 12xy? And now this formula already, you know, this xy value also is given to you, 6. The 144 minus 12, 6 are 72. The answer is 72 only, right? Do you understand this?
So can you tell again?
Okay. See, 9x square plus 4y square is equals to 144 minus 12xy. Till there you understood, Sai Charan?
Sir, how, sir?
First line you understood in this, first line. How? This whole square part, this you understood? Or,
Sir.
This whole square part, this one you understood or not? This yellow part?
Sir, yeah. Sir. Yes,
now,
sir.
Now squaring both sides, you will get this much or not? A square plus mile plus 2ab plus b square. This one you can get or not? Tell me if you are not getting second step.
Yes, sir.
Third step is, we are just bringing 12xy to the other side. Why? Because we want the value of 9x square plus 4y square only. Is it clear to you? 9x. Then 144 minus 12xy. The 144 as it is, and 12xy is there. Xy value already you know. If you put the value of xy in this, you will get the value of 9x square plus 4y square. Is it clear, Sai Charan?
Sir, got it.
Anyone having doubt in this? Anyone of you?
No, sir.
It's clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
So polynomials, I'm going to make you a plate one quiz, okay? Based on polynomials.
Yes, sir, I have a doubt.
Okay, ask your doubt, then we'll just play one quiz. Ask your doubt. Say, Sai Charan.
Where can we do any factorization? Means if you ask, like, factorize this thing. So can we do factor theorem, sir, for anything?
What is factor theorem? What is factor theorem, Sai Charan?
Sir, to find the factors of the given polynomial.
Okay. If they ask to find the factor, you can use factor theorem.
Using like division methods.
Division method. Division method.
Sir, that is only factor theorem, sir, I think.
Dividing by something, right? Means like this one. Means something you'll be given to upper and down something will be given. On dividing, you are saying, right?
So no, sir. So like taking x minus 2, like trial and error method, sir.
Trial and error method, right?
Yes, sir. Like if there is 2x square minus 3x minus 2, sir. So we are taking like x plus 1 and doing as it is factor and then...
You can just put, but you'll get one factor. Then again, you should do, if three factors you should want, then what you do? Again, you should, then you should divide, right?
Yes, sir. They got like, when they get the remainder as zero, then they will get the factor.
Yeah, if you get remainder as zero, then that is a factor.
Yes, sir.
If you're not getting the remainder, then you own not factor.
Yes. Sir means here he got like x minus, he kept like trial, sir, x minus 2, sir. So he got as the quotient as 2x plus 1, sir. So x minus 2 and 2x plus 1 are the factors of that.
Yeah, that you can do, but you should so much, sometimes it won't come. Means,
sir, means you can do it for that method when it is like four numbers, sir.
Okay, fine.
So, like it is a bi-quadratic.
Yeah, power 4, no? That one you are saying, right?
No.
Because you can't factorize only, no, all the time. That's why you just trial and error method you're doing. X to the power 3 is given, then also you're using trial and error method like that. Understood?
Yes, sir. I want this, sir, because means when he gave more than binomial, sir. Binomial is 3 terms, sir. So, if we give 4 terms, sir, then can we use this, sir?
You can use 4 terms. To binomial, you can directly factorize also. And put the value also you can do.
Sir, but in middle, there will be 2 numbers, right, sir?
That's see what I'm telling you, one example. Like, suppose power 3 will get, no? X to the power 3 plus x square plus 2x plus 1. So here, we know, here you can't do only. Here you can't factorize. So obviously, you should use trial and error method first, okay? Understood? Yes, after putting one getting the, suppose you are getting x minus 1 as a trial and error method, they should divide this polynomial, then you'll get 2 more answers. Understood? Then that answer will come in x square plus x plus form. This form will come. Then you can factorize this. Understood?
Okay, sir.
Because if 3 is coming here, x to the power 3, 2, x and 1, then you can't do by that normal method. It's like a factorization method. You can't split only here, right?
Yes, sir. Yeah.
That's why first we are doing with trial and error method. Then after getting the quadratic polynomial, we are just going to factorize. Understood?
Okay.
Someone told. Okay. Okay, only one just quiz I'm just playing over here. Polynomials only we'll play, right? Polynomials. In chat box, I'm just putting that. See, I've sent already. You'll have joined now. Who left? Sai Charan left. Ulasthya, you are joining?
Yes.
Okay. Slating, it's one able to join. It's making able to you to join. minus चार minus दो minus दो plus तीन एक
So I finish it though, guys. Sir, I'm done with the quiz.
Shriyanvi, have you done?
Professor, done, sir.
Can you hear me, Sriyanvi?
Yes, sir, I'm done.
Hello.
Hello, sir.
Sriyanvi, can you hear me?
Yes, sir.